So as a vegetable gardener, one of my core focuses is how can I squeeze as much food as possible into the space I have. I know things like soil health make a massive difference. Understanding different kind of planting methods and spacing between plants. But there's one thing that can make a massive difference, and it might not be what you're expecting. Now, we all have our own favourite or go-to varieties of vegetables. Perhaps they taste great, or they're suitable for smaller spaces, or we know that we're going to get consistent results from them. For example, I always grow the beetroot variety of Boltardi every single year because I know I'm going to get consistent results. Now, what if I told you that one of the best ways of increasing the yields from your growing space is to push the practicalities of gardening to one side and instead focus on the abundance of vegetable varieties we have to choose from in order to optimize the way that we garden. In previous years, when I sit down and I do the annual seed order, I find it really easy to just go through and buy all of the seeds that I'm familiar with, all of the varieties. But I realize that I'm actually missing out from discovering and finding new opportunities because I'm stuck in that comfort zone. You see, the great thing about each individual variety is that it has its own characteristics that define and distinguish it from the other varieties of that particular crop. Perhaps it has an interesting color, maybe it has a kind of quirky flavor, it could be fast maturing or heavy cropping. This year I've decided to do something different. Instead of choosing the main variety and then perhaps another variety to grow as well, I'm choosing a small handful of crops and I'm attempting to grow as many different varieties as possible of these crops. And I'm going to be growing these alongside the control variety or the one that I'm most familiar with in order to do a comparison so I can find out which varieties stand out to me the most and which ones give me better results. Now, what is better? Well, better can mean anything. It's really down to your individual growing goals. But the great thing about trying different varieties is no matter what your goal is, no matter what you want to get from your garden, you will get results that will make a positive difference. If you choose, say, a handful of crops each season to trial new varieties alongside, say, your current or your favourite varieties, then it's not going to take you long to build a go-to list of varieties that are bespoke to your garden, your goals, and also your climate. Now, just stop for a minute and imagine your garden full of all of your A-list varieties. How different would that look? How different would that feel from today? I'm just very much at the start of this, but I think it's a fun journey and I invite you to come along. But how exactly do we get started with experimenting and testing to find the real gems of the varieties that we want to grow? To start with, I would suggest that you ignore leafy salads and instead focus on the core staples of the garden. These are things like kale, onions, broad beans, carrots, and potatoes. Now you want to pick around 3 or 4 nominated crops. For me this year, it's going to be kale, fennel, and leeks. Once you've chosen your nominated crops, the next thing to do is to make a note of what is either your current favourite variety of that particular crop or what is that default one, the one that you find yourself growing every single season. Now, for example, my default kale crop or variety is going to be dwarf green curled. Now, once you've made a note of that, it's now time for you to check out your favourite seed suppliers, either through their catalogues or go onto their websites and read through all of the varieties that they have for that particular crop. And you need to be reading these with kind of the question or the goal of, could this potentially become my new default, my new favourite? Now, you want to choose at least 4 other varieties to try out alongside your default. But if you have more space, then I encourage you to maybe try 5, 6, potentially 7 different varieties. In front of me here is the brassica seed bed. This is my preferred way of starting brassica seedlings. They can be close and intensive, and then I'll transplant them out into their final position. So along with the dwarf green curled kale, I'm growing six other kale varieties, which are hungry gap kale, cottager's kale, red Russian, dazzling blue, asparagus kale, and East Frisian palm kale. My core focus of trying these different variations of kale is to not only find ones that work really well in terms of winter hardiness, but also to compare their flavor. So whatever crop you've decided to trial the different varieties, you want to grow that default variety along with the other varieties in the exact same way as possible. For example, starting off all of my kale in the same place and then transplanting them into the same raised bed. You want there to be as much consistency as possible with the growing. The reason why you want this consistency is because it's going to give you a far more accurate representation when it comes to comparing and contrasting and seeing if there are any that really stand out. One other really important thing that you've got to do to make the test or the experiment as fair as possible is to grow multiple plants of the same variety. By having multiple plants, you'll get a more accurate and fair representation of each variety, and it's going to make it a lot easier for you to compare the different ones versus just growing one plant of each. Chances are that is not going to give you a proper fair result. When it comes to harvesting, you can either take into account the observational differences, the weight differences or the yield, and also the taste differences, or you can compare all three. Now, another thing that I recommend you look at is how healthy is each variety looking? Are there any that are showing particular weakness, such as extra pest damage? It's really important, I think, to have an overall view so you can make a far more kind of informed decision on what is, in your opinion, the ultimate variety that you want to grow. Once you've harvested all of the varieties of a particular crop and you've made the notes, you now want to run these through a process of elimination. The goal with this is to find the best performing variety that you've grown out of the mix. Now, in front of me here, I've got our main onion bed, and most of these onions are Sturon. Because I've been testing different onion varieties, I found that Sturon has performed the best here, which is why it's a staple variety of onions that I'm now growing. Once you have your chosen variety, you want to make a note of it on an A list, your variety A list. Now, for me, this is something that I'll use whenever I'm creating an annual seed order. You could use a notepad, but for me, I'm going to use something like Google Docs because I have countless notepads and I don't want to risk losing this list. Now, for me, gardening is not just about productivity, but also enjoyment. So I'd actually recommend that you create a second list, such as a specials list. These might not be your staple varieties, but these should be varieties that you know a little bit special. Perhaps they're something like a crimson flowered broad bean or an albino beetroot, just something that you enjoy growing, because I think it's really important to have a list of the varieties that truly excite you. So you're both covering productive varieties, but also the ones that bring you a little joy and magic into your gardening. This list of varieties is very much going to be unique to you, and it's going to help you to optimize the way that you garden in order to hit the goals that you set. So if you just do a small handful of crops every single year, quite soon you're going to build a clear picture of those kind of standout varieties, and you can just imagine the kind of positive impact that's going to bring to your gardening. Now, one thing to note is that you should also be flexible with it. It can be a list that changes constantly, because maybe in a few years' time your friend tells you who lives down the road about this new kale variety, you give it a go and you're just blown away by it. So I think being open to change but having that kind of go-to resource that is tailored for you is one of the most rewarding things and one of the best investments that you can put into your gardening journey. So when you're growing the different varieties, it's really important to obviously label them, but I also like to keep the empty seed packets back. So if the label slightly rubs off and I can only see a couple of letters, I've got that as a reference point. But also, I really like to make sure that I write down the varieties on my planting plan. Summer is just around the corner, and that means the first of the harvest. And when you harvest something, there's an empty gap. And if you're struggling with creating a really effective planting plan, where it allows you to plan in ahead and have a monthly outlook on your garden in order to do things like succession planting to increase your productivity, I've got an online course. It's really affordable, and it's around 10 lessons showing you how to create a productive month-by-month planting plan that offers you a seamless transition into the following growing season as well. So if you want to find out more, there'll be a link down below, and there's a coupon code for 20% off using PLAN20. And I really hope you find it useful. One of the great things about gardening is that there are so many different ways that we can utilize to increase the productivity and the enjoyment of our growing spaces. And I hope this video has given you a slightly different angle, a slightly different approach that you can take towards creating that long-term gardening dream that you have. So if you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to ask me down below in the comments section, and I look forward to seeing you guys again soon.